Hello and welcome to another video about GammaRay. I am Giuseppe D'Angelo, a software engineer at KDAB. In this video, I'm going to show you how we can use GammaRay to enable or disable several advanced visualization modes for doing Qt Quick profiling. Qt Quick comes with a few ways to visualize several advanced profiling techniques. There are ways built in within Qt Quick to allow you to show some performance aspects of Qt Quick, namely, for instance, how many draw calls Qt Quick is using to render your scene, or things like if your scene contains too much overdrawing or contains too much clipping. These features are built in with Qt Quick, so if you have Qt, you can use them out of the box. The thing is that when we actually use these features because we are interested into doing some performance work on our software, these are not so easy to use. I'm going to show you why is that. When you enable these features, you enable them in a way that you can actually see the performance aspect, but somehow you cannot use your application anymore. That sounds a bit tricky, so let's see an example because I think a picture speaks more than 1,000 words here. So what I have here is a small example. It's coming straight from the Qt examples, so you have it. It's the contact list example coming with Qt again. I'm going to run this example so we can see how it looks like. So here it is. It's a contact list, as the name says. You see all the contacts here. You can interact with them, open them, close them, and it's got several other features. Now, suppose that I want to know how many draw calls is Qt Quick using to draw this interface. Especially on low-end hardware, this is a very good question because the more draw calls, of course, the worse the performance. So there is a way built in within Qt Quick to answer that question. The way is called visualize the batches. If you want to know more what this actually means, I'm going to leave a couple of links in the video description so you can check out some more content about this. I'm just going to enable this visualization here and we can understand what it means together. So in order to enable this feature within Qt Quick itself, we need to export an environment variable. The documentation tells us the right environment variable to export. It's called QSG Visualize. We need to set it to a value. This value will be something like batches or overdraw or clipping and so on. So we can go inside Qt Creator right here in the Projects tab, in the Run settings. And down here, we can set additional environment variables for our project. The one we want to add is indeed called QSG Visualize. So I'm going to add it. So this is called QSG underscore visualize. And I'm going to set, for instance, to overdraw because I want to visualize the overdraw on my Qt Quick application. So now when I run the application again, the rendering changes drastically, right? This is the very same application. This is the very same code as before. And the application is fully functional behind the scenes. It's just that Qt Quick is rendering something extra on top that allows me to understand what is, if you want, the 3D structure of my elements in the scene, which elements are drawn on top of which other elements. And if we do that too much, of course, if we have too many opaque elements hiding too many other elements, we may have some performance problems. So we don't want that to happen. And this visualization is exactly what we need to debug that kind of issue. Now, as I said, this application is fully functional, right? I can interact with it. It's a bit hard to see, actually, because this visualization is now hidden behind the overdraw. But perhaps you can spot here that I'm indeed opening the details of this contact behind the scenes. I'm scrolling the list of contacts again behind and so on. So suppose that you have a problem with this particular application, and you want to do this kind of debugging, but you don't want to do it in the main screen. Maybe you need to navigate to the right position, to the right screen inside your application, and then in there actually do this kind of overdraw visualization or so on. Well, actually doing it is kind of challenging because you don't see anymore the actual content of your application. You see it covered by this overdraw visualization. And if we enable some other debugging technique, such as the batches, we actually don't see anything anymore. That's kind of bad, right? We want to be able to actually use this amazing capability coming with Qt Quick. And that's when GammaRay can give us a huge hand. What GammaRay is able to do is to enable and disable these visualizations at runtime. So we can start our application normally, navigate to the point where we actually want to do this kind of debugging, and only then run GammaRay and tell GammaRay, please enable the visualization I want. I'm going to disable this visualization mode for the moment because I don't want it to be enabled as soon as I start the application. So now I can restart the application and indeed the application looks fine. I can just use it. I can click on buttons, interact with it, enter text and so on, right? And the important part is that suppose that at this moment in time, I want to visualize the overdraw or the batches or the clipping and so on. So what I can do is now launch GammaRay and attach it to the application. We have seen how in an earlier video of this series, so I'm just going to do it. I click here, I click on the shortcut that I've installed, and now I attach to the running example. So here it is. This is GammaRay now attached to the application. The application is here. It's still running perfectly. All I need to do now is go inside the Quick Scenes module of GammaRay. And there are these four buttons here in the UI, or these five buttons, I should say, that are able to visualize or to visualize overdraw batches. So they can enable or disable all these modes. What I need to do, for instance, if I want to visualize the overdraw, is click this button right here. And as you can see, now our application is in overdraw visualization mode, right? So we were able to enable this modality at runtime. I can also do something else, for instance, visualize the batches. Now, clearly the application looks very, very strange, but again, there is a meaning to what you're seeing right here. If you want to know more, once more, please go and follow the video, the links in the video description. And yes, the application is still fully usable. It just looks very, very weird. But if I want to do this again from an inner screen of application, GammaRay is the only way to go. So that's all I have for you today. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much for listening and see you next time.